What's happening, guys? This is going to be a tutorial on wand spinning, and I'm going to show two methods of spinning a wand. Now, the reason why I'm doing this is because I just want to take a break from cards, for one. But really, I was surfing on YouTube, and I saw somebody do a trick, and they had a wand. And they tried to wave the wand, but what they did was they rolled it on their fingers like this. And then it occurred to me, there's probably some people who don't know how to spin a wand properly. So, to me, I figured, you know, if you have a magic wand, you know how to do it. But I guess, unless you see it done, how would you know? So here's two ways to do that. Okay, the first spin I'm going to show you is the one I just did. And what you want to do is you want to hold it in the center with these two fingers as if you were going to write. Okay? And the wand will be placed between these two joints on the index and these two joints of the middle finger, okay? But it's held as if you're going to write something. And you turn your hand palm up towards the ceiling to start. Okay? What you're going to do is take the back of your hand and bring it towards the ceiling. Now the thumb is not going to be used whatsoever. So you hold it like you're going to write a pencil and then just remove the thumb. Bring the back of the hand towards the ceiling and straighten your index and middle finger like this. Okay? The two actions are going to happen at once. Fingers straighten, back of the hand goes up. You continue the rotation until your hand looks open like this, fingers spread. And then swing it around, and at the end of the spin, you place your thumb back on to stabilize the spin. I'll go over that again slowly in a second. To just have it keep spinning, you just keep doing the same thing over and over again. But each time it goes to the return position, my thumb, for the briefest moment, contacts the wand in the center just to kind of make sure that everything's stable. Okay? So now you can have an object in your hand, do a magical pass with the wand, and that's that. Not really used for card tricks, of course. And the action from this angle, slowly. Back of the hand towards the ceiling, fingers straighten. Now return the hand to its original position, like so. Like this. Like this. Once more. Okay. Before I show you the next spin, a couple more from this angle. I wish I could explain the second half of the spin more clearly than just saying your hand will continue its motion, but I really don't know how to explain it. All I can do is say for the first part, the back of the hand goes towards the ceiling. And like that. So maybe if you see me a few times and you do it, you'll be able to get it. Okay? So again, up to speed. That's a wand spin. Just to clarify, the first 50% of the wand spin occurs below the forearm, and then the second part of the wand spin is above the forearm. So again, the first half spins below the forearm, and then the rest of the spin is above the forearm. Below, above. Below, above. Okay? So that is that. Here's another way to spin a wand. I believe it's called the drummer's spin. It's a little tricky. And I believe it's called the drummer's spin because this is how drummers sometimes spin drumsticks. Although the drummers that I've played with, I think, tend to do this. I think this is something more that Tommy Lee would do. He's a big one for drumstick spinning. But I have seen drummers use this second method to spin their sticks as well. Now I'm restarting this cleanly because this is kind of tough to do slowly. You hold the wand the same way as before, except this time it's not dead center. I want you to play with it a little bit. as to where to place the hand. I'm going to show you what it looks like. This is the dead center. If I hold my grip a little bit forward, this is what will happen. Like that. I'm catching the very, very end of it. Okay? Here's the dead center. Now I'm going to place my hand before the dead center. If I were to do it like this, I'm going to lose the wand probably. That's what will happen if you go before the dead center. So, now that we know the exact spot, a little bit after the dead center, here's what's going to happen. The grip is the same, but this time you keep your thumb there. You're going to take your index finger, and you're just going to crank it inward. And what's going to happen is the wand will rotate in the air around the thumb. When it gets to here, you just quickly catch it. Okay? I'll show you again. Slow motion. Crank the index finger inward. And then it flies by itself, spinning around the thumb. And then you catch it. Okay? From the front, it would look like this. Crank the index inward towards yourself. So this point goes towards my body, goes towards my body. It will automatically go around the thumb, and then I catch it. When it's in this position, you're in the classic tap position. Okay? If you want to tap on a cup, if you want to tap on a box that has somebody's finger ring, or just tap, that would be a good spin. Okay? So that is what I think is called the drummer's spin. Now these wand spins, they may be difficult if you have one of those cheap plastic wands, but you could probably do it. You could probably do this one. I don't know if you could do the drummer's spin. So my original one, I dropped like $50 on. I guess Michael Amar has one, I think, for only $35, which is a nice wand. But you need a wand with some weight. And I lost my wand, so recently I wanted to replace it, but I didn't want to drop that much money. So I found a Bang wand. This is called a Bang wand. It was only $15, and I figure until I replace it for a better one, this will serve its purpose for now. It has metal ends, and this handle here is wood. Actually, I think it's metal as well, but it's a lot lighter. It's a Bang wand, which means in the center there is a metal object that will slide back and forth. I've removed it and thrown it away because I don't want to use it for a Bang wand. And what you do is you have, you know, those caps, those little round cap things, little paper caps. You unscrew these ends here, and you take one of those paper caps, and you place the cap inside this end of the wand. Now, when you go like this, the heavy weight inside rushes forward, slaps into the cap, and it'll make this big sound. It's a Bang wand. It makes a bang sound. Again, I just threw out the insert, knowing that I would never, ever, ever, ever actually use it for a Bang wand. Plus, caps smell anyway. And it has this clunky thing floating around in the wand. But this is a great way to have a weighted wand without having to spend $35 or $50. If you plan on using a wand, you know, if you're going to do like cups and balls or something like that, and some other applications with wands, you do need to drop the money though. You know, I mean, eventually I'm going to splurge for either the Amar wand or some others that I've seen. So, that's it on magic wands.